Hi, this is Brandon with Android Advice and Tutorials. Here I'm going to do a review of the Elixir Selfie Smart Poll. And as you can see, it's for Android and Apple devices. First of all, I'm rarely ever in front of the camera. I'm usually behind it. But I figure it's easier to show you this by actually holding it. This is the Smart Poll itself. It does come with two mounts for your phone. One will be a smaller mount, which does extend to fit different size phones. Both mounts actually extend. This one's actually attached now. So it extends, and then this top part pulls in and out to kind of grab your phone and grip it. The smaller one you would use for like your iPhone 5 or just smaller devices themselves, or if you don't have a case on your device. This one, being the larger one, allows you to put larger phones like the Note for the Google Nexus 6 now, things like that. And it also has the retractable part to hold the phone in place. Okay, now I have a Nexus 5 here, so I'll go ahead and show you kind of how that sits in place. And it's really nice the way it does. You can basically just set it in, take this back part, lift it up, and your phone's in place. Okay. Easy enough. Let me go ahead and turn the phone off. So it's in there. It's not going anywhere. It won't fall out. It's in there snug. It's got kind of a soft cushion on the inside, which is nice to hold it still. And as you can see right now, it's flat. There's a piece here that you can turn to flex it whichever direction you want. So when you have it on the pole, you want to flex it and then tighten that down. And then as you can see, it's a good snug pull. We've tried a few different ones, and they seem to be kind of flimsy at the top. And sometimes they don't fit all different types, size of phones. Okay, two other things here. One is on the back. You can see here there's a power switch to turn it on and off, as well as a micro USB plug for charging it. Okay, so we'll go ahead and turn it on just so that it's on. And you'll see a blue light flickers on when you turn it on. And then second is the button right here. Okay. Now that button allows you to hold it naturally by the rubber grip, and it's a good snug rubber grip, and take the picture with your thumb, which is nice. Now, it is a steel extension here, and that steel extension allows you to extend it out pretty far, as you can see here. It's very far away. I've got it almost to the camera, and I'm leaning back on the couch. I think it said it was a little over 1,000 millimeters in length. You'll have to do your math to figure out how long that actually is. There's also, it actually goes further than this, but I didn't want to pull it all the way out. There's also, I don't know if you can see it in the video, but there's a groove here. Now, what's good about that groove, for one, it doesn't twist back and forth. So you can't, when you're holding it, you don't have to worry about it, like, the phone flipping over because it's a pole. That's what keeps it sturdy and in place. Okay, and you can see I can wiggle it around and it doesn't go anywhere. Okay, now once you have that in place, let's go ahead and turn this on and go ahead into the camera. And I will go to front facing camera. Okay, now I'm gonna kind of turn a little here so you can see. And there it is. Shows your front-facing camera, so you're looking at the camcorder itself. Okay. And now I'll go ahead and hold it out. Take a picture of me next to the camera so you can kind of see. Let's swipe this over so we can see what it looks like. And there you go, from a distance. So, you can rarely ever get your selfies from that far away. So let's go ahead and take it out of the mount, and I'm going to take a selfie by hand. Just so you can see the difference in the distance and kind of how this works. Okay. So, here's what we have. We have one with me holding it out as far as my arm will reach. And then we have one with the selfie pole. And you can see you capture a lot more with that pole. So it's really nice. Great stocking stuffer. It's this time of the year. And you can find them, you know, decent price. I'll put that in the written review itself. But if you have any other questions about it or concerns, just leave them in the description of this video, or head on over to Android Advice and Tutorials and leave us a comment there. Thanks for watching.